the News 8 Storm Team Forecast with Chief Meteorologist Joe Calhoun.
Okay, I've showed you Harrisburg at the top of the newscast. Now we're going to play, they put the name up. I was going to say, Guess the Sky Cam. Effort. Yeah. Thanks, Janelle. Very good. Very good. Very good guess there. Yeah, it is a little dense out there. The fog is dense. Why? Well, we started clearing out. We had that moisture out there. Look at it. It's gotten so bad it you can't even see it out there anymore. 36 degrees, the dew point pretty much the same. So watch for the fog. Dense fog advisory is up to 1. I got a feeling Weather Service is going to extend that to morning. It's not everywhere. You go a couple blocks, it's fine. Then all of a sudden you can't see anything. It's getting chillier, though. We're going to stay pretty much in the low 30s overnight, and then in the 30s to around 40 through the morning hours, the fog will gradually, I think, start to lift. Should be back up into the 40s tomorrow. Again, a day above normal with temperatures. That'll be a 3 or 4 in a row now with mostly cloudy skies. So our January thaw continues, but there could be a stray shower in the afternoon, another disturbance coming over us. They look very impressive on the satellite, on the weather maps, but just not producing a lot of precipitation. Could even be a snow shower or rain shower. Again, that dense fog advisory, it's up through the, I got a feeling they're going to extend it through the morning hours now. 30 degrees in Harrisburg, in fact, fell down to 29 ceilings grow. So watch some of those back areas. You know, you get a little bit of dampness on the roadways. It may just look a little wet, but there could be some slick spots. Not out of the question. 36 up in Mifflintown, 37 New Freedom. Most areas are in the 30s now. So a little chillier. Nothing on the radar, though. Yes, or the day's rain is now pulled up into New England. The center of that storm is now pulling away from us, and drier air is trying to move in behind that. But it's going to be short-lived. I want to look at the big picture. There's one storm. You see a very distinct comma-shaped cloud pattern here. You see another tailing cloud pattern back here. And then all the way back into parts of Vancouver up that way. Yeah. British Columbia, there's another storm. They're all lining up. One storm from today, one for tomorrow, probably one coming in sometime on Friday. But none of them have a lot of moisture with them. They're coming from Canada, so obviously not a real big moisture source, but the jet stream continues to bring them from Canada, a big ridge in the jet out west, and that continues to bring them east at a rapid pace, so they don't really stick around very long. Clearing skies right now, that's the reason for the fog. Southerly flow, though, continues ahead of this next system. And again, it could be in a rain or a snow shower as we go into the afternoon hours tomorrow. Then they die out. And we may have another system along the coast, so we could have some clouds Thursday morning. Wouldn't even rule out a flurry. Then I think we break back into some sunshine. But already on the map to the west, here comes the next system coming in. It's probably going to bring some snow showers by the time we get to Friday. Gradually, we're getting colder. 40s. Then 30s, then mid-30s. I think Saturday's probably the coldest. We get a little bump up, probably coming into Sunday and Monday. Again, by Tuesday, there is that next chance of another weak system the way it looks at this point. So weak weather systems, but you got to keep a track on them. One of these systems, I just got a feeling. One of these
One of those punches is going to land.
Yeah, I hope not.
All right, thank you, Jeff.